Wow, Blast from the Past. So here is a game I have not touched for I think about 10 years. So the last time I played this, I think maybe was 2007, around there. It's a really long ass time ago. So I felt like hopping on the single player and trying it out once again, just to get some old memories back. So this is Aliens vs Predator 2 on the PC. Damn, man, the graphics back then, I can see already. Wow. Okay, so that's Rykov. So, the intro to the Predator campaign is talking about Rykov's past and this grudge he has against a specific Predator who injured him. As you guys will see in the opening cutscene here. Damn, man. Oh, there he goes. Just look at the graphics on the trees. Like, they're really bad, but back in 2001, it was like, wow, we can jump on trees now. That'd be pretty cool. Awesome. Oh, check it out. There's the lasers. And then he blasts him off that giant bridge, and he falls down, and I think he breaks his leg. Or his spine or something. Something like that. And we got some soldiers here trying to look for him. So the story with Rykov is he gets injured during that encounter with a Predator. I think he becomes like paralyzed or he can't walk or something like this. And he starts buying drugs off the black market to enable him to walk again. So here we have the Predator ship. I guess it's going down to the planet. Oh my god, dude, the graphics, look at everything. It's just so old. I wish to be effective. Pain won't make you effective. General Rykov. Oh my god, those textures. Those blocky hands, those polygons. Oh man. No, sir. It's slowing down. Sir, it's changing course. Zeta region.
We have remote monitors there. Good. I want visuals.
Alright, here we go. So they got a camera on one of their sectors, checking out the incoming Predator ship.
Ivan, call the containment teams.
Yes, sir.
I'm not reading anything. All right, so here we go. We're going to start off the Predator campaign. We got thermal vision. There's my cloak. I only got two weapons to start off with. So I got the wrist blades and the spear gun. The spear gun is only good for headshots, really. It's actually not going to decloak you when you fire it, but it's kind of weak on the body. Like, primary shots do a single shot, and the secondary fire shoots three shots in random order. So it's never in the same spot, but they're kind of clustered together, so it's kind of like maybe a long-range shotgun, in a way, kind of. Oh my god, dude, it just brings back memories. Like, this game is just so goddamn old. I don't understand why this game is not on Steam yet. Like, I mean, the first game got put on Steam, you know, with good record time, and then AVP3 got put on there. But this game is, you know, back from 2001. Like, why the heck is it not on Steam yet? I really don't understand. Oh my god, yo, that Predator laugh. The memories, man. Oops, oh, I forgot. I have to do the crouch jump. You gotta crouch and then jump to get the really high jump in there. So, we'll go down this way. There's... Oops, okay. That is the energy sifter. I pushed the wrong button. So, we'll just snipe this dude out. Oh, there we go. Awesome. You can actually retrieve the spear gun shots you shoot on the opponent after they die. So, if they die in very, like, high walls, then you pretty much can't get your ammo back. Got you. So, you have to conserve your ammo with the spear gun, or if you do kill them, just make sure to pick up the spears after you kill them. Let's get these wrist blades out of here. Let's see what they can do. Oh, man. Wow, the sound effects. Let's get this scientist over here. Come here. It just feels really weird. It's been over 10 years since I touched this game. Okay, there we go. We'll get up. And crouch jump there. Whoops. Oops. Okay. We'll take the ladder. There we go. Alright, here we go. We got a couple Marines over here. We got two way back here. Maybe I can snipe them off. Oh! Oh, right! The Light Predator actually kills them. Damn it. Is there something weird like the melee combat? Whoa! Why can't I see them in the Predtech vision mode? The screen is like all black. I don't know what's up with that. Like the game is so old, like it probably has trouble adjusting to brand new graphics card or something. I don't know. Kill everyone. Everyone must die. Oh, can't get up there. Where the heck is he? Because I can't use my Predtech vision mode to locate him. I think he's over here somewhere. I recognize this part. Oh, there he is. I see him. There's a Light Predator, so I think he gives me the spear. Secondary melee combat weapon. What's up? Oh my god, the graphics. Wow, dude. I know I play AVP Classic from 1999. I play that on Steam for multiplayer and sometimes for some commentary videos and stuff. I know that game is old as shit. But it's just, I haven't touched this game in like 10 years, and just coming back to it now after playing, you know, AVP 3 so much and playing all these other games, and the screen is black, can't see crap there. Hopefully I won't have to use that vision mode in the campaign. So like I was saying, like, I mean, coming back to this game after 10 years and just seeing the graphics, it's just, oh my god, they're so bad. Like, for 2001, they're fine, you know, they're decent, but looking at it now, it's just like, wow, man. Everything is like really blocky, squared, and pointy edges. And I mean, it's fine. I'm not saying it's bad to a point where, you know, it sucks. That's not what I'm saying. It's just weird seeing it again, I guess. So I got one. There's two. Can we get three headshots in a row? Let's go for three. Got him. Three. Wow, okay. Here we go. You know, this reminds me, I lost like all the mods I made for this game. All the sound packs, all the skins, all the vision mods, interface changes. I lost everything. Because this is back in like, what, 2001 until like 2007? I was doing some mods for this game. No, I think I was doing it until 2006. Or 2005. No, the thing is, I know I didn't play it for 6 years straight. I played it from like 2001 until I think around maybe 2005 or 2006, around there. I played the game for like 3 or 4 years, and then it's pretty much was like dying out in multiplayer, and the community was kind of dwindling down, and AVP News was pretty much shut down. There's nothing there. So what ended up happening is I took a very long break, and that's around the time when I started my YouTube channel, and I just wanted to focus on fighting games. But yeah, during that time period, I was moving around, and I kind of lost the CD-ROM that had all my files. So, yeah. They're all gone. But they might be hosted on some websites. I might have a look around. I don't know. We'll see. Although, I don't really plan to play this game in multiplayer. I don't think it's working online. I think it's broken. Because I believe many years ago they shut down the master server, which is the main server you connect to in order to see available servers. So they shut that down so you can't even connect. I think after that, someone in the community made a master server fix file where it will still locate other servers. So it was pretty much community supported after that time. I don't know if that file still exists. We'll see if that is around. I'll try to install it and I'll see if anyone is playing multiplayer, but I mean, it just feels kind of weird. Like, I haven't touched the game in 10 years and I'm not as quick as I used to be, man. I'm not that young anymore. Yo, there's a heavy predator. Yo, that was the predator I loved to use in multiplayer for all the matches I played. I love the heavy predator. He was slow as fuck, though, but he had like 400 health points. Awesome. Okay, I got the disc. Good stuff. Now I just gotta find targets. So let me have thermal on just in case I find somebody. And I think I found someone. Alright. Let's chuck the disc. Oh my god, wow, the sound effect. Oh shit, I think I threw it before it actually fully locked on. Just recall the disc. Let me chuck it again. There we go. Wow, it actually got the head. I thought it aimed for the chest. Must have been a lucky shot there. Holy crap, a headshot again? Damn. Wow. Now, the other AVP game I sometimes feature on my channel, which is AVP Classic from 1999, the Predator disc in that game is really overpowered. It's fucking broken, it's stupid, and I say that because I believe it has a turning capability of up to maybe, what, 90 degrees, maybe 180 degrees? That's a lot, but I'm just saying I've seen some really weird shit with that disc in that game. Like, it turns around a lot trying to get its target. Like, it barely misses. So anyways, in AVP 2, they fixed that. So yeah, the game is a little bit slower, but at the same time, it's a little bit more balanced. Like, for example, the disc in this game, AVP 2, does turn trying to hit its target if it does try to move sideways, but it doesn't turn as ridiculous as it did in the first game. Like, in this game, it's going to turn, I think it was 30 degrees, I believe. Let me chuck that over there. Get him. There we go. Let me knock this guy over with the disc from here. Doesn't even know where I am. He was like looking around like a lost fool or something. Alright, so the energy sifter recharges my energy. And my medicomp will use my energy to heal. So I guess you gotta find all other predators to collect all your weapons. So, anybody over here? Oh, I remember, whenever you're lost, if you're trying to jump onto platforms, if you see that really weird looking plant, that was kind of an indicator of where you had to go. It was a weird thing, but yeah. It was something that not a lot of people actually knew about it, so it's just there, whatever. Oh, wow. The spear. Oh, jeez. Wow, I used to love this weapon in multiplayer. Oh, that's freaking hard to use. I mean, sure, I'm killing like the AI bots right now. These are easy. I mean, these bots are just fucking dumb. But in multiplayer, that shit is like not easy to use. Oh. Ah, aliens. Xenomorphs. Damn cockroaches. There we go. Oh shit, there's still Marines alive. Let me just chuck that there. Yeah, when you throw the disc, if you do it when you're cloaked, it forces you to uncloak, but there's a way you can kind of bypass that, which I remember. As soon as you start the animation to throw the disc, you can uncloak and then recloak. It's somewhat helpful for multiplayer. So I'm going to recharge, and I'm going to heal first, because I remember there's a Praetorian at the end of the stage. I just don't know where. It's somewhere around here. So I'm all leveled up with my health and energy, so I'm going to keep the disc on because it does some really good damage. I know it's around here somewhere. Somewhere here. I just don't know which way. I forget where it's going to come from. Where is it? Where is it? Oh, fuck. I know it's somewhere here. Where is it? Oh, there it is. I see it. All right, come on down. Let's go. Let's go. There we go. Hit you once with it. Can I get him twice before he gets close? Throw the disc. Oh, he's still alive. Wow. There we go. Alright, it's dead. Alright, awesome. Alright, cool. So, that is it for the first part of the Predator campaign. Stay tuned for part 2. I'll see you guys later.